My name is Garrett West. I'm the producing artistic director of the organization. Before we begin, we have a few announcements. We've got the exits on the two ends of the house here, down the down floor, and on the upper floor, we do have an emergency exit. Please silence all your cell phones. I know some of you also were having trouble loading the program. That's because I don't think you guys got the Wi-Fi password. So it's yes, and it's the, capital T-H-E, space, Beatles, capital, like the name. I'm sure you can figure that out. Speaking of which, also, we are live streaming the show, just as we do all our productions. So please, please don't film with your own phone, because it's going to be preserved for all time. We've got a professional videographer. Also, please, no photos. Refreshments are going to be available in the lobby during intermission. They'll actually be in the cafe area. Lights will be on, you'll see them. And we also have 50-50 going on. Just a little bit about our group. We started in October just as a bunch of friends who wanted to do something because theater was not happening, obviously, with the pandemic. So we did one Zoom production that led to doing another Zoom production that led to us doing a live show that led to us creating a whole organization. And our whole motto has always been to present free and accessible theater for everybody in the Capital District and surrounding areas. So try not to sound like the PBS guy, but if you donate, that would really help us continue our mission. So I also want to say a few thank yous to people who either donated or sponsored us or really just helped us get off the ground with this by lending us things. Aaron Bramer, Kayla Cromie, Bob and Kathy Densmore, Robin Dickinson Sawyer, Olivia Divas at the Adirondack Theater Festival, Myrtle Hawksby, Lifepath Living Center at Livingston, and Water Elite, Nikki Lights, Benny Murphy, Jonathan Newell, and the Hudson River Music Hall Productions, and Perillo and Schenectady Today, Prince of Lutheran Church, Stephanie Reveille, Maggie Reynolds in the Daily Gazette, Janet Sherman, Joe Sweeney, Lorraine Thompson, Skylarville Community Theater, Steve Vaughn, Kathy Waldorf, Emily Weaver, Dan Lisa West, and Patrick White. So, big thank you to them. That's all I got for you, and I really want to get off the stage anyways. So, without further ado, welcome to Bunbury Players.
Thank you. blushing flower. As a matter of fact, she rented by the hour. The day she died, the neighbors came to snicker.
Well, that's what comes from too much pills and liquor. But when I saw her lay out like a
in the dark. So I'm really pleased about being here. You know, we are the Bunbury Players. Now, some people have said to me, who the bloody blazes of Bunbury? Well, if you know a little bit about theater, Oscar Wilde wrote a marvelous play called The Importance of Being Earnest. And in this play, one of the main characters, Algernon, likes to go out in the country and create all kinds of havoc, and he goes by the name of Bunbury. So you might say we're a bunch of people who are around trying to create havoc. Now we're gonna try tonight to really entertain you. Now, many of you, I'm sure, have heard of that light, frothy, lovely little musical, Sweeney Todd. So now we have my friend, Courtney here, who is going to tell us what it's like to make the worst pies in London.
A customer! Oh, I such a rush, what a hurry. You gave me such a fright, I thought you was a ghost. I thought many pages, such a nice seat. All I know is that I haven't seen a customer for weeks.
References famous people and places with the most unbelievable rhymes. Well, here's Russell and Heather to present one of the best known of the songs. You're at the top, From Anything Goes.
At words poetic and so pathetic that I always have found it best, instead of giving them off my chest, to let them rest.
Summer night in Spain. You're the national gal, you're purple celery, you're celery.
The only one that we know of and is memorable is The Music Man, and it's considered a classic even after 60 years. In this musical, Harold Hill, the titular character, who is actually a charismatic con man, travels to the Midwest trying to sell boys' marching bands to the unsuspecting town folks, even though he doesn't know a darn thing about music. How? By trying to get the population into believing you got trouble. Hit it, Joey.
Well, we got trouble, my friend. Right here, I say trouble, right here in Bear City. Why, sure, I'm a billionaire player, so the money from the same goes money from the same. Like I said, that the hours I spend with a cue in my hand are golden. Help me cultivate horses with a cool net and a keen eye. Sure, take a try, find ironclad lead to yourself from a green-up billiard shot. Just as I say, it takes judgment, brain to maturity, and score, and above my game. I say they boo, and take and shove a fall of name. And I call that slump. The first big step is on the road to the depths of the dead. One day I say first, and this is from a wine from a teaspoon, then beer from a bottle. And the next thing you know, your son is playing for money in a pinchback suit. Horse race gambling, not a wholesome trot race, no, but a race where they sit down right on the horse. But the season stuck up job boy, sit on day and hatch, make blood boil, well, I should say. Now, friends, let me tell you what I need. You got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pockets in a table. Pockets mark the difference between a gentleman and a bum with a capital B that rhymes with P that stands for pool. And all week long, your rivers sit in the middle of the way. I say, you're a young man, leave friend of it. Spread it right away, there are noontime, summertime, chore time too. Get the ball in the pocket, never mind getting deadlines pulled from the screen door patch where the bees get pounded. Never mind puppets anymore until your parents are caught with a sister and a young Saturday night. That's trouble, they still got lots and lots of trouble. Think of the kids in the naked mug of shirt tail, young ones peeking in the pool ball, putting her to school, you got trouble. Trouble right here in the city. Trouble with a capital T that rhymes with P that stands for pool.
Friends, the idol brings the devil.
city. Heed this warning before it's too late. Watch for the telltale signs of corruption. The minute your son leaves the house, the street bundle is knickerbockers below the knees. Is there a nicotine stain on his index finger? A dying novel hidden in the cornbread. Is he starting to memorize jokes from Captain Billy's whiz band? Are certain words creeping to his conversation? Words like sweat and soldier all day. Well, so my friend, you got trouble.
Oh, we got trouble.
Right here in River City.
Right here in River City.
With a capital T that rhymes with P that stands for pool.
That stands for pool.
We surely got trouble.
We surely got trouble.
Right here in River City.
Right here.
Remember the many, Plymouth Rock and the Golden Rule.
We still got trouble.
Oh, we got trouble. We're in terrible, terrible trouble. That game with the 15th number balls to the Devil's Duel.
Devil's Duel.
Oh, yes, we got trouble, trouble, trouble.
Oh, yes, we got trouble.
First of all, when the curtain rose, you didn't see a bunch of beautiful legs on the crossroads. You saw an old lady sitting in a wet rocker, churning butter. Yep, and the characters themselves told soliloquies. They told you what their interior life was like. And others, like our Adrienne, here played by Kat, tried to explain why she just can't say no.
And it's so much of rushing and not knowing what to do. I know it's right across the southern tan. I hear a lot of stories and I reckon they are true. About how girls are put upon my man. I know I mustn't fall into the pants. But when I would go better, I'm just a girl who can't say no. I didn't
You know, many actors have to contend with the fact of their physicalness. Being people like myself, who have deep voices, often play the heaviest. I guess that's why when I go to the show, I really enjoy the villain characters, because I think, I could do that better than you. But usually, the bad guys do have the very low songs, the ponderous song and everything. Which, in the next show, Annie, it's kind of nice that our heroine is a contralto. So here are Katie, Courtney, and Jason to tell us what it's like to live on Easy Street.
I remember the way our sainted mother would sit and croon us a lullaby.
She'd say, kids, there's a place that's like no other. You gotta get there before you die.
You don't get there by playing from the rule book.
Oh, no, you stack the aces.
You load the dice. Mother dear, oh, we know you're down there with Ned. How can we follow your sweet advice to Easy Street? Easy Street, where you sleep till noon.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
She
resurgence and finally bringing audiences of children and families back to Broadway. It's just phenomenal because we really need, you know, we've got to train kids to be people who appreciate the theater in the future. In this new song, expressively written for the musical version, Belle, here played by Stephanie, is locked in the Tower of the Beast so that her father can be set free. Now alone, she sings a song of what home is really about.
Mm-hmm.
in the secret garden, brothers Archibald and Neville have to face the fact that they were both in love at the same moment. And one day, Mary Lennox comes to live with them, and both men are forced to deal with the fact that in Mary, they see Lily's eyes. Strangely quiet, but now the storm simply rests to strike again. Standing waiting, I think of her.
More than just now.
you want, what you don't. So which do you pick? Where you're safe out of sight and yourself, but where everything's wrong. Or where everything's right, but you know that you'll never belong. And whichever you pick, do it quick, cause you're starting to stick to the steps of the palace. It's my first big decision. The choice isn't easy to make. To arrive at a ball is exciting and almost your goal is scary. And it's fun to escape when you know you can't leave, but you have to be wary. There's a lot that's at stake, but you stop looking up.
Sit down and rock in the boat. And this ought to help you get into a good mood.
I dreamed last night I got on the boat to heaven. By some chance I had brought my dice along. And there I stood and I hollered, "Hey, someone bade me." But the passengers, they knew right from wrong. Oh, sit down, you rock the boat.
Sleepwalk, sit down, you rock the boat.
And the devil will drag you under by the sharp lapel of your checkered coat. Sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down.
Sit down, you rock the boat.
Passengers were bound to resist. For people said, beware,
you're on your
That was fun. Okay. It's 1917, in Russia. The Tsar and his family have just been assassinated. There's a rumor running around Moscow that the youngest daughter, Anastasia, somehow escaped. Well, many women tried to claim that Romanov fortune. And one of these people was a little Anna. Anna is now trying to go to Paris, where the grand duchess, the grandmother of Alexander, is living, and prove to her that she is Anastasia. And here she is on a train, traveling on a journey to the past. Let's hear what Emily has to say about that.
$105. Ticket number
301. Did I hear a bingo?
Read it again. Read it a couple times.
It is 230.
Girls today in society go for classical poetry, so to win their hearts we must quote with ease Aeschylus and Euripides. One must go home and leave me go, Sophocles, also Sappho. But you know Shelley and Keats and Poe, dainty Debbies will call you a dope, but the poet of them
well, and if still she won't give you a bonus,
from Adonis. Brush up your Shakespeare, and they'll all count out.
Sings now.
And they'll all count out.
I'm fucking
they'll all count out.
Luckily, everything's going to reopen this October, September. The song, All I Really Want, was originally conceived as a confrontation between a woman and her partner about their troubled relationship. On stage, it's about the character MJ's struggle to keep her family's squeaky clean reputation. Recently, in the wake of the Black Lives Matter movement, it has been used as a rallying call for social justice. Here's Katie with her interpretation of All I Really Want.
Yeah. your bills, your wrecks, your deadlines. So when you think you're gonna die, what did you long for the next distraction?
Like being locked up in a tower all your life, hidden from everyone besides your abusive guardian. Well, that's the life of Quasimodo. They lived this in Hunchback of Notre Dame, the novel by Victor Hugo, the subsequent Disney animated film, and the stage musical. Here's Dan again to sing of what it would be like if this hunchback could just spend one day out there.
Safe behind these windows and these tenements of stone, gazing at the world down below me. All my life I watch them as I hide a deep alone, hungry for the mysteries they show me. All my life I memorize their faces, knowing them as they will never know me. All my life I wonder how it feels to pass a day out above them, part of them.
Thank you.
sends chills up my spine. Another musical based on a French novel is Phantom of the Opera, and it holds the distinction of being the longest running Broadway show to date. In this scene from the mega musical, Raoul, a young man from Christine's past, returns to her just as she becomes taken under the spell of that phantom. But Raoul, played by Tim, is able to break the spell and get Christine, Stephanie, to fall for him instead of, "In here, all I ask of you." With Alphaba by giving her a makeover. Heather's interpretation of this song is just a little bit different from the original. Better watch and see for yourself.
what they need. And even in your case, though it's the toughest case I've yet to face, don't worry, I'm determined to succeed. Follow my lead, and yes, indeed, you will be popular. You're gonna be popular. I'll teach you the proper points when you talk to boys.
Hey.
don't think I want to get on the bad side of any one of those ladies. Now, let's go back to musical comedy history and revisit an old chestnut, the pajama game. This tells the story of a factory that is on strike and is struggling to get an attempt at a pay raise, 7.5 cents. Pretty progressive for 1954. Factory timekeeper and Heinze, played here by Joey, is initially suspicious that his girlfriend Gladys has been cheating on him. However, in this scene, he admits to his friend and secretary Mabel, played by Kat, that he will treat her and promise to be never jealous again.
Heinze! Heinze!
I'll never be jealous again, Mabel, never.
That's easier said than done.
I can do it.
I knew it. But let's take an example, just for fun. Picture this. You're sitting there waiting for her to come back from a date. Here she comes. Her blouse is unbuttoned.
And that's where I really decided I had to get involved with theater. And now I'd just like to sing my favorite song from that show. To dream the impossible dream. To fight the unbeatable foe. To bear with unbearable sorrow, to run where the brave dare not go, to rot the unrightful wrong, to love pure and chaste from afar, to try when your arms are too weary, to reach the unreachable star. To follow that star, no matter how close, no matter how far, to fight for the right without question or pause, to be willing to march into hell for a heavenly cause. And I know if I'd only be true to this glorious quest, that my sister, Emily and Andrew, and I'm sure they know a little bit about fighting.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
It's okay.
Anything you can sing, I can sing softer.
I can sing anything softer than you.
No, you can't. I can drink my liquor faster than a flicker.
I can drink it quicker, and I can even sicker.
I can open any safe
without being caught.
Yes.
That's what I thought, you crook.
And you know you can hold, I can hold longer.
I can hold any no longer than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No,
yes,
you can.
Here, Beth is played by Julianna and Joe by Courtney. Some things were meant to be.
When you were first born, not an hour old, I told Marmy,
Beth is mine.
Everyone has someone special in the world. And I have you, my sweet Beth. Give me a task to do.
Let's pretend we're riding on a kite. Let's imagine we're flying through the air.
We'll ascend until we're out of sight. Light as vapor.
Thank you.
Farewell to this wonderful audience. We thank all of you who came here tonight and to all of those who are watching us on the internet. We hope that we've given you a few smiles, maybe a little choked up every now and then, but we hope we've entertained you. And we hope that you will come back again and again to see us. Before we say our final goodbye, however, we want to leave you with one last song from a musical that builds itself as a musical within a comedy, The Drowsy Chaperone. In this show, all the people are drunk. And so we're going to go off with this, maybe with a drink, or two, or three, or four, maybe in the back of the car. This is Stumble Along.